Thanks so much, Brittany. Dealing with, beautiful conditions across the region. However, we are still looking at some warm temperatures across the region, so just make sure that you have plenty of water and bust out the shades as you step outside. We are also monitoring that chance for some isolated storms this afternoon. Now, the severe weather threat has been lowered compared to what we had yesterday. Even still, for the northeast quadrant of the state, that slice, and some of the far eastern plains, we have the possibility for some of these storms becoming strong or severe, so make sure you stick with us as we monitor any storms that crop up. One very easy way of keeping yourself ahead of the storm and monitoring those storms right along with us is by accessing our KRDO.com app. Now, you can see several things via our app: our video forecast, interactive radar, current conditions, very helpful tools as you are out and about on this Tuesday. Live HD Doppler radar showing quiet and dry conditions. We don't have any real stormy or precipitation activity so far this afternoon. We've only seen just some storms impact the very northeast sliver of the state. That's about it. Here's a look at what Skycast is projecting throughout the rest of the afternoon. Here's a look at 4 p.m. A few increasing clouds anticipated along the I-25 corridor, especially near the New Mexico state line. Also, we could see some of these spotty showers and storms develop in the higher terrain. That's really the location where we have the best chance of seeing these storms, along with the far eastern plains. Even still, we can't rule out a few of these spotty showers and storms trying to impact the I-25 corridor, so stick with us as we monitor all of those conditions for you. Here's a quick look at just how much rain we could see, and this is our rain tracker, which stops us tomorrow morning. So very limited amount of rain anticipated for some of the higher terrain locations in the San Luis Valley, but everybody else looking to be dry. Even still, a couple other forecast models are hinting at the possibility of seeing some spotty showers in the lower elevations, so just best to be prepared. Over the next couple of days, we are sticking with warm and dry conditions, but just a few spotty storms possible Wednesday afternoon. A mixture of sunshine and clouds for your Thursday in Colorado Springs. Friday into Saturday, things are looking a bit more soppy, especially on Saturday, so make sure you have backup plans to any outdoor activities you may have scheduled for the weekend. We keep in the chance for afternoon showers and thunderstorms all the way through next Tuesday. It's a similar story in Pueblo. However, the next couple of days we're leaving completely dry with temperatures reaching the upper 90s. Now, on Friday, we usher in more monsoonal moisture in across the region with temperatures dropping to the lower 90s, still staying pretty warm. On Sunday, we take a brief break from some of these showers and storms with a few of those storms on Monday. 93 tomorrow in Canyon City with some of the 90s the rest of the way on out, and then we drop to the upper 80s on Saturday with just a wet and unsettled pattern Friday and all the way through Saturday. Finally, in Teller County, we'll reach the upper 70s today with the 70s the rest of the way on out, and daily chances for afternoon showers and thunderstorms. It is that time of year, so again, be weather aware and stick with us. We'll be talking about that outdoor forecast next.
All right, thanks, Abby.
Well, we have new information this afternoon on the shooting investigation.